Lord be with you. My sisters and brothers, welcome to this solemnity. Today on Epiphany, we celebrate the manifestation of Christ, the light of the nations, to the Magi who came from the east. And at the beginning, as we prepare for this celebration, we are invited to raise our hearts to Him and to offer ourselves to God together with Christ and say to Him, Lord, speak, Lord, work in me. Lord Jesus, you gather all peoples into the peace and justice of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you are the light of the world. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are worthy of all praise and homage. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
Rise up, splendid Jerusalem. Your light has come. The glory of the Lord shines upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick clouds cover the peoples. But upon you the Lord shines, and over you appears his glory. Nations shall walk by your light, and kings by your shining radiance. Raise your eyes and look about. They all gather and come to you. Your sons come from afar, and your daughters in the arms of their nurses. Then you shall be radiant at what you see. Your heart shall throb. For the riches of the sea shall be emptied out before you. The wealth of nations shall be robbed. Caravans of camels shall fill you, dromedaries from Midian and Ephah. All from Sheba shall come, bearing gold and frankincense, and proclaiming the praises of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit, namely, that the mystery was made known to me by revelation. It was not made known to people in other generations, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit, that the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
When Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of King Herod, behold, magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We saw his star at its rising and have come to do him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it has been written through the prophets, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance. Sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the child. When you have found him, bring me word, that I too may go and do him homage." After their audience with the king, they set out, and behold, the star that they had seen at its rising preceded them, until it came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star, and on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. Then they opened their treasures and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
When we've lost something, we search for the item with an intensity that corresponds to the value of the item lost. When we've lost a few pennies, it won't probably bother much. If it's a $100 bill, it may bother more and seem longer. When we've lost the only set of car keys in the house, when it turns over the house upside down, parents have lost a child, they will probably never, ever stop searching. Today, in this gospel, we hear of those men from the East, the Magi. They have gained scientific insight, and they probably also studied the sacred writings. And both apparently moves them to embark on a great search. A long journey, they follow a star. And with them they have gifts. It's clear the diligence of their search and the long journey that goes with it corresponds with the great value that they assign to the one for whom they search, that newborn king whom they seek. They don't mind the discomfort, the troubles and the risks that often came with traveling in antiquity. In Africa, we say, poor because of our safari. I'm sorry that you had to travel. There's something preserved of that. And in Jerusalem, they have to contend with King Herod, who is so hungry for power. He's a schemer. He is double-tongued. And finally, they arrive. Because the eyes of these seekers are open, they can recognize the wonderful work of God in the poor child in Bethlehem. It needs for them a seeing with the eyes of their hearts. They use their own knowledge. They are willing to learn from the scribes in Bethlehem. And yes, they are ready to be surprised by God. Then, beyond the reference that is due a king, they fall down, they prostrate themselves in worship. They become the first representatives of the peoples who see Jesus at his birth. They acknowledge, as was said earlier in Matthew's gospel, that in this child, God is with us. Often, artists depicted in paintings the effect that the visit in the stable had on the Magi. The rough hands of the old men become tender, and their faces marvel as they kneel down at the manger and present their gifts to the child. The gifts symbolically fit with the recipients. The gold represents Jesus' royalty. The incense points to his divinity. The myrrh points us toward his suffering and death. Then the Magi are warned in a dream not to return to Herod, and they depart for their country on another way. That they are open to such guidance that comes to them from God shows again that they are people who listen inward. And certainly this new route that they take also indicates something of the fact that if we become new people, a new avenue has opened up for them. The ways that they now choose in their lives are new and different ones. In our first reading today, we hear the prophet Isaiah proclaim a light. The light of God, God's glory, it is granted to many nations. One day, so Isaiah says, nations and kings will walk by this shining radiance and will joyfully come with their gifts and riches to praise and adore God. And of course, we see this prophecy fulfilled in Jesus Christ and in the vision of the wise men. Today's solemnity of Epiphany, the word translated means manifestation, expounds for us in greater fullness the meaning of Christmas. Jesus is the light of the nations, as the Second Vatican Council points out, Lumen Gentium. He is the Messiah, the shepherd and ruler of his people Israel and of all peoples. And in him, as the preface of this feast proclaims, God has renewed all humanity in God's immortal image. In him, through him, God gives all of us, all humans, a share in his divine nature. My sisters and brothers, Jesus is the light, the savior of all humankind, and we, like the Magi, are called upon to receive the light and to manifest it to others. The Magi can be models for us. One, they were seekers. They made use of their mind's natural light in order to gain knowledge. And they were open to a revelation that could only come to them from God. Prayer, regular and persistent prayer is necessary for such openness of mind and heart to come about. Secondly, the wise Magi were also people of action. They were ready to set out to act upon what they understood. They took risks. They gave up the comfort of their lives at home for the sake of the journey. And the result was that they found God, not in abstract concepts, but in the person of Jesus Christ. Also for us, finding God is often very concrete. We find God in concrete, real human beings. Finally, the Magi were transformed by their experience. They returned on a different route. It was impossible, we could certainly say, for them to be silent about what they'd heard and seen. They become persons of manifestation themselves. Cardinal Kurt Koch, the president of the Pontifical Council for Christian Unity, once wrote, as the Lord's appearance in Bethlehem was plain and inconspicuous, so his epiphany in the lives of Christians will occur ordinarily and not sensationally. And the Lord appeared, and as the Lord appeared in our world humanly and in solidarity with the people, his appearance can be extended through the church today and bring encouragement and liberation. Since Christmas, God's epiphany wants to continue through the lives of Christians in this world. Light for the blind, Lumen Gentium, is the motto of our missionary Benedictine congregation. Light for the blind, that's what all of us can mean as a result of our search for God and of our pilgrimage to Bethlehem. Lamb. Let us profess now our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial of the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son,
and the
Son is adored in
the
Father. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
As co-partners in the promise of Jesus Christ, we see fit to ask God for our needs and the needs of people from every nation on earth.
For the Church gathered from all the nations, that her holiness may shine out as a guiding star to bring Jesus to those who are still in the great darkness, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, that God may endow them with his judgment, so that they may govern his afflicted ones with justice and respect for the human dignity of each person. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the faith and persevering search of the Magi may inspire us during dark times of our journey, but only the light of a great star leads us on through the night. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For missionaries who carry the good news of God's plan to incorporate all the families of the earth into his people, and for the benefactors who so generously support them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For astronomers and other scientists who study the earth and the heavens in order to better understand God's creation and our place in it, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved departed ones, especially those who have died during this Christmas season, that they may come to rest in the radiant presence of the Savior whom they sought in the shadows of his passing room, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of light and love, you graced us with your only Son, born in the holy palm of Bethlehem, and guided the Magi to him so they could carry the news to foreign lands. Listen to our prayers and guide us as we spread the good news. In the name of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that our sacrifice of thanksgiving may be acceptable to God, our almighty and loving Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good works of all church.
Look with favor, Lord, we pray, on these gifts of your church, in which are offered not gold, frankincense, or myrrh, but he who by them is proclaimed sacrificed and received, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ, as a light for the nations. And when he appeared in our mortal nature, you made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, he sings a hymn of your glory, and without end we acclaim. So that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Thanksgiving, this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with our Holy Father Benedict, Saint Scholastica, Holy Father Basil, Saint Gregory Nazianzen, and with all of the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence, we rely for our faith come.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm with faith and charity your pilgrim church mother with your servant Francis our Pope and George our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, religious, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
But deliver us from evil.
graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another the sign. Blessed are those called to the wedding banquet of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Go before us with heavenly light, O Lord, all days and every day, that we may perceive with clear sight and may hear with true affection some mystery in which you have built us to participate through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I wish you a peaceful feast day and a good week. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
All your heads for God's blessing.
May God, who has called you out of darkness into his wonderful light, pour all in kindness his blessing upon you, and make your hearts firm in faith, hope, and charity.
Amen.
And since in all confidence you follow Christ, who today appeared in the world as a light shining in darkness, may God make you too a light for your brothers and sisters.
Amen.
And so, when your pilgrimage is ended, may you come to him, whom the nature saw as they followed the star, and when they found as great joy the light from night, who is Christ the Lord.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.